I'm really excited to be sitting up here today because of the alternative. Our team, I thought, did some really nice things last night, and I think we're going to have to play better tomorrow. South Dakota State, we played them 2 years ago, and they're a very well-coached team. Their kids play very disciplined basketball. They have a lot of weapons, and you better come out ready, and you better know what you're doing against them.
Questions?
Tara, Mark Hovenden from KDLT in Sioux Falls. I know you've played South Dakota State a couple of different times. This team's probably a little different, but in general, is it a little scary playing a team that has that sort of underdog, throw it all, caution to the wind type of situation?
We play against it a lot, and it is just because, like a team like, maybe even South Dakota State, who didn't win the regular season but, won their tournament. I think sometimes you feel like a team like Jennifer's team, with USF, or there are some teams that are playing with house money. And they just, can be very relaxed and play, play really hard. I think South Dakota State, has a great tradition of women's basketball. The thing that I'm really surprised about is what bracket they're in. I got confused when I saw them. I just got confused with that because I just thought, wow, usually they give a team a chance to play maybe, in the home arena. And talking with Aaron, he just said, wow, it's a great facility and great enthusiasm for women's basketball. And besides, I guess, I kind of just scratched my head on that one. But then, and watching them play, Kale said, they come out, they're very aggressive, and it's a one-game season.
David in the back.
David Brown from Midco Sports in Sioux Falls. It's sort of been alluded to that maybe some people thought SDSU should have deserved a higher seed than the 12 that they got. Based on their non-conference schedule this year, they played the likes of Maryland, Notre Dame. Do you sort of know firsthand that this isn't just any mid-major team? This is a team that's played with the best of the best.
Well, not just looking at the scores, but we've played them before. So, we know how tough they are, and we know that, we're going to have to, we're going to have to play really well. And I think we understand their team, a little bit what they like to do and kind of the strengths of their team. But, I think the committee, it's a really impossible job. And I think they work really hard to watch as much basketball as they can and do the best job they can. So the seeding, who knows? And, right now they've already proved that, they're not a 12. They're a 5. So, we're playing a 4-5 game.
Janie?
Hi, Tara. Aaron shared a little bit about the game in Mexico and how you impressed him with your knowledge of South Dakota and their program and what some of the challenges are with the Native Americans and situations. Do you pride yourself in really, getting to know an opponent that way? And it meant a lot to him at that moment.
I think that... I think it was a while ago, but I think we might have had a conversation about kind of the Nike N7 and just, the fact that we were going to do some clinics on some reservations actually in Montana, and I might have talked to him about whether he would be interested. But, South Dakota is a beautiful state. I've driven through it. Stopped in there, went to the Black Hills, and it's really, they do a great job, and they have more than one great team. I think South Dakota and South Dakota State are both, excellent programs. And we played, when we went to Ames, we played South Dakota, and, they have great basketball, and I think that's a reflection on the coaches, on the universities, on, the state itself, just, supporting women's sports. And so I like to get to know, I like to understand kind of where they're coming from and the style they play. It's really fun. I met some of the South Dakota State fans yesterday. Just, they came up to me. I took pictures with some of their kids. And I think it's great when you have that, you know, group traveling and supporting women's basketball. So, you know, we're really, really excited that they get to stay. I'm sorry it's bad weather for them, you know, while they're here. But, you know, we want to play a great game. And, you know, I don't want to take anything away from the game itself, but it's really exciting to see women's basketball growing all over our country the way it is.
Cheryl?
Cheryl Coward, HoopFeed.com. Miami's Katie Meyer said that you can talk about South Dakota State's three-point prowess all day, but in the end, they were stronger at the rim. And what are the particular challenges of facing a team where all five players on the floor can shoot, score, dribble?
Right. That's a huge challenge. And, you know, I talked with Katie, actually. They were practicing 2 days before the tournament, and I went over there. She goes, Tara, South Dakota State's really good. I said, yeah, I know. We've played them, you know. And they do give you that challenge of spreading the floor. They pass well. They execute very well. They play with a purpose, and you know, just you know, outstanding players that play within themselves. They don't try to do too much. So it is a very big challenge for us. But I think we have a pretty good team too, and we need to come out, and we know we have to defend the 3-point line. But you can't just get so absorbed with that you give them all boards, which they got against Miami. You've got to defend in the paint, which, you know, they got transition shots and just point blank layups. You know, you have to do some. We have to do some things to frustrate them and not let them do what they like to do.
Go ahead, Janie.
Tara, Aaron also joked about could you stay out of his recruiting territory after this? Do you go into South Dakota and Minnesota very much?
Well, you know, we've had a player a long time ago from North Dakota. South Dakota, I can't think of anyone like that. I don't think we've ever had anyone on our team since I've been here from South Dakota. You know, obviously Minnesota is for everybody, but you know, they have a lot of you know, not necessarily, I mean, you know, local talent, Minnesota, South Dakota. But, you know, if someone has the grades and they're that good, we're going after them. It doesn't matter where they're from.
Go